Let's now take a look at brute forcing session IDs. And this is actually a very, very simple attack. And I want to show you just what this means. Now let's imagine that an attacker has gone to a website and they get a session ID like the one that we see in the URL just here. It doesn't matter whether it's set via the URL or via a cookie. It's just a little bit easier to demonstrate with the URL, but you'll see the relevance to both in a moment. Now what brute forcing means is that we're just going to keep trying different possible session IDs until we stumble across one that is actually attached to an authenticated user. So for example, we can look at this URL and say, hey, the session ID does look rather enumerable. It looks like it complies to a pattern. A pattern that we could step through just by incrementing the values. So for example, what if we change that last digit from 6 to a 2? Well, the first thing is that the response has come back and it's now actually incremented the URL. So instead of 62, it's 67. So there probably wasn't a valid session on the server for session ID 62. Let's try 63, see if we get anything for that. It's incremented our session ID again. We're now at 68. We'll try one more. Let's try 64. And here we can now see in the navigation bar, "Hello, Troy." In this case, us as the attacker has simply been able to guess a valid session ID of a victim, an authenticated victim. So keeping in mind that we are here in Firefox as the attacker, and clearly we now have session ID number 64 and it's valid. Now this was possible because over here in the background, there's a Chrome session that's also authenticated. Same session ID, but it's logged in as me. So the Firefox session has been able to hijack the Chrome session simply by brute forcing, or really just guessing, a very educated guess at that because it's just simple enumeration, but it is still guessing a valid session ID. So this is just simple enumeration. Let's go and have a look at a slide just to illustrate this very clearly. So here's what happened. Very simple case of having a victim and an app, and they're talking backwards and forwards with a particular session ID. And then the attacker comes along, and the attacker is effectively just asking the server, hey, does the session ID ending in 762 exist? And a response comes back which implies that no, it doesn't. And the response that we saw in the browser just then is the server actually gave us a different session ID because the first one wasn't actually valid. So the attacker then enumerates. It goes to 763 and asks the server, and then 764, and it just keeps going until it gets a valid response. Now, of course, this is something that can be highly automated. You'd script this out, you'd run it on bulk. An attacker doesn't sit there in the browser manually incrementing the URL. Now, of course, because this is such a brute force style approach, just simply enumerating and guessing numbers, it's also the sort of thing that can be remotely detected. This would be very unusual behavior to continually see requests for invalid session IDs come in from an attacker. But detecting it is not something that applications normally do. And really, there is a bigger risk at stake here that needs to be fixed. And we're going to cover the solution to this later on in the course in a subsequent module. For now, though, this is the fundamentals of brute forcing a session ID. Pretty basic stuff. Let's move on and look at one final attack, and that's session donation.